for our service, short service of Holy Communion on this Trinity Sunday. And it's lovely to be able to welcome you here today in the congregation and those watching from home. Just a quick COVID briefing for any new faces in the congregation. So I hope you've used hand gel on your way in, and I ask you again to use it on your way out. Please maintain 2 metres social distancing and keep face coverings on unless you're taking part in the service. When it comes to communion, I'll bring the wafer to you. Please just stay in your seats, but if you'd like to stand and receive, that's fine. Just hold your hands out, but if you'd rather not receive, just keep your hands low and then I'll offer a blessing instead. And as we leave church at the end of the service, if you'd like to leave from the rear first and engage in any social distance conversations outside of church after the service. So we'll just have a few moments of quiet to reflect on what brings us here today, and then we'll begin with our opening. Grace, mercy, peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
And also with you.
Let us call to mind our sin, our failure to value the love of others, and our failure to love as Christ has loved us. And we say to you, most merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, we confess that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbours as ourselves. In your mercy, forgive what we have been. Help us to amend what we are, and direct what we shall be, that we may do justly, love mercy, and walk humbly with you, our God. Amen. May the Father of all mercies cleanse you from your sins and restore you in his image to the praise and glory of his name through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Amen. And we stand to say the glory of God. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God our Father.
Amen.
And the collect for this Trinity Sunday. Holy God, faithful and unchanging, enlarge our minds with the knowledge of your truth, and draw us into the mystery of your love, that we may truly worship Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Amen. We sit for our first reading.
First reading taken from Isaiah. In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord sitting on a throne, high and lofty, and the hem of his robe filled the temple. Seraphim attendants above them each had 6 wings. With 2 they covered their faces, with 2 they covered their feet, and with 2 they flew. And one called to another and said, Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory. The pivots on the threshold shook at the voices of those who called, and the house filled with smoke. And I said, Woe is me, I am lost, for I am a man of unclean lips, and I live among the people of unclean lips. Yet my eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts. Then one of the seraphs flew to me, holding a live coal that had been taken from the altar of a pair of tongs. The seraph touched my mouth with it and said, Now that this has touched your lips, your guilt. guilt has departed, and your sin is blotted out. Then I heard the voice of the Lord saying, whom shall I send, and who will go for us? And I said, here I am, Lord, send me. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
We stand for the gospel reading.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Now there was a Pharisee named Nicodemus, a leader of the Jews. He came to Jesus by night and said to him, Rabbi, we know that you are a teacher who has come from God, for no one can do these things that you do apart from the presence of God. Jesus answered him, very truly, I tell you, no one can see the kingdom of God without being born from above. Nicodemus said to him, how can anyone be born after having grown old? Can one enter a second time into the mother's womb and be born? Jesus answered, very truly, I tell you, no one can enter the kingdom of God without being born of water and spirit. What is born of the flesh is flesh, and what is born of the spirit is spirit. Do not be astonished that I have said to you, you must be born from above. The wind blows where it chooses, and you hear the sound of it, but you do not know where it comes from or where it goes. So it is with everyone who is born of the Spirit. Nicodemus said to him, how can these things be? Jesus answered him, are you a teacher of Israel, and yet you do not understand these things? Very truly, I tell you, we speak of what we know and testify to what we have seen, yet you do not receive our testimony. If I have told you about earthly things and you do not believe, how can you believe if I tell you about heavenly things? No one has ascended into heaven except the one who descended from heaven, the Son of Man. And just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whoever believes in him may have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish, but may have eternal life. Indeed, God did not send the Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him. Here ended the lesson.
Thinking a lot about what to preach on this morning, mostly because I know that as a new preacher, that preaching on Trinity Sunday is quite a difficult task. A clergy friend said to me, don't try and be clever and preach on the mysterious doctrine of the Holy Trinity. Most people will know the basics. It's got the Father, it's got the Son, and God, the Holy Spirit. I think that might be true, and it's certainly something that I think people get cleared up in the early days of their exploration of faith. Yesterday there was a service for choral evensong here at St Michael's, and the anthem was Tchaikovsky's famous hymn to the Trinity, and I was really struck by one line in particular. Holy, holy, holy,
merciful and mighty, God in three persons, blessed Trinity. I almost just had that as the strapline to my sermon and kept it as the shortest sermon in the world, but I just thought it really needed some more exploration about what the Holy Trinity means to us and for us. This morning's Gospel reading is one of the most quoted passages in the Bible, and the language supports the notion of being a born-again Christian, spiritual birth or rebirth. From conception to delivery and beyond, the process of birth is quite intimate. A lot of it happens in the dark, figuratively and literally. So it seems especially appropriate that Nicodemus and Jesus have this conversation at night. Not just because darkness offers a measure of protection and secrecy for Nicodemus away from the prying eyes of the other Pharisees, but because Jesus speaks here of a mystery. In response to the question that Nicodemus asks about being born anew, Jesus does not really provide a clear explanation. But his words about water and spirit, about birthing and love, Jesus offers something better than an explanation. He extends to Nicodemus and to us the invitation into a relationship and a journey to transformation. The wind blows where it chooses, Jesus said to Nicodemus in that nighttime visit, and you hear the sound of it. You do not know where it comes from or where it goes. So it is with everyone who is born of the Spirit. Perhaps it was this quality of the Spirit that inspired early Christian folk in Celtic lands to choose the wild goose as an image of the Holy Spirit. Unpredictable, untamed, the goose flies in formation with its companions, offering strength that makes the journey easier. The person of Jesus gives us a window into what God is like, an example of how to live our lives. The Holy Spirit is God working with us and among us. Since doing a little more thinking and more reading about the concept of the Trinity, it seems to me that to explain God as a Trinity is inherently describing God as communal and loving. One God in three persons whose shared mutual sacrificial love spills out into the world. And I think that ultimately we are called to be a church in a similar way, loving, respecting and caring for each other in a way that spills out into our villages, into our towns, into our communities, in a tangible, beneficial and fulfilling way. The Trinity is not merely an idea to be grasped, but a mystery to be experienced and a relationship to be entered into. In the Gospel reading, what Christ desires most for us is to grasp the love of God, the love that sent Christ into the world to show us the face of God, the love that claims us and calls us, the love that invites us to enter into the relationship with the one mystery. A love that drenches us and draws us into a new life. And so God's essential and core being has always been a giving and receiving of love. First through creation, then into sending God's only Son into the world, showing just how much he loves us. And now, as the Spirit bears witness to God's ongoing love for us and for all creation. In the coming days and weeks, and in these moments here and now, how will you look for the presence of the God who seeks you with constant love? How will you be in a relationship with others and show them this same love? May we at all times and in all ways live out this love. And so let us pray. triune God, in this new season, may we know the presence of the God who dwells within our days, the mystery of the Christ who drenches us in love, and the blessing of the Spirit who bears us into life anew. Amen.
Thank you, Matt. I think it should be a tradition that the vicar does not preach on Trinity Sunday. Do you agree? We'll write that one down and make sure that always happens. So, let us stand together to declare our faith. Do you believe and trust in God the Father, the source of all being and life, the one for whom we exist?
We believe and trust in him.
Do you believe and trust in God the Son, who took our human nature, died for us, and rose again?
We believe and trust in him.
Do you believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God and makes Christ known in the world?
We believe and trust in him.
This is the faith of the Church.
This is our faith. We believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Please do be seated. Before our prayers, it's my privilege to publish the banns of marriage between Stephen John Cocking and Amy Yvonne Oakley, both of this parish, and between Nicholas John Panton and Melissa Sophie Baines, both of this parish, having a qualifying connection with St John the Baptist, Bisborough. These are both for the first time of asking. And if anyone has any reason, knows of any reason in law why these persons may not be married, you are to declare it. And I hope you join me in praying for Stephen and Amy and Nicholas and Melissa as they prepare for their special day. So we remain seated, or we kneel for our prayers. To the phrase ending mercy and grace, please would you respond with the words, "We plead before your throne in heaven." Your mercy and grace, we plead before your throne in heaven. We come boldly to the throne of grace, praying to the Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. For mercy and grace, we plead before your throne in heaven. Father of heaven, whose love profound a ransom for our souls has found, we pray for the world created by your love, for its nations and governments. We lift up before you the situation in Jerusalem and pray for a ceasefire and the continued ceasing of hostilities. Extend to them your peace, pardoning love, mercy and grace. We plead before your throne in heaven. Almighty Son, incarnate Word, our prophet, priest, redeemer, Lord. We pray for the church created for your glory, for its ministry to reflect those works of yours. Extend to us your salvation, growth, mercy and grace. We plead before your throne in heaven. Eternal Spirit, by whose breath the soul is raised from sin and death, we pray for families and individuals created in your image, for the lonely, the bereaved, the sick and the dying. We lift up to you the names of all those in our prayers and those who are not well known to us personally. And we lift up before you the memory of all those whom we love, yet see no longer. Breathe on them the breath of life and bring them to your mercy and grace. We plead before your throne in heaven. Thrice holy, Father, Spirit, Son, mysterious Godhead, three in one. We pray for ourselves, for your church. Bring us all to bow before your throne in heaven, to receive life and pardon, mercy and grace for all eternity, as we worship you, saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Merciful God, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. We stand for the feast. Peace to you from God our Heavenly Father. Peace from his Son, Jesus Christ, who is our peace. Peace from the Holy Spirit, the life giver. The peace of the triune God be always with you.
And also with you.
So please do offer one another a sign of grace within your household groups or at a suitable social.
Thank you.
we say together the First Communion prayer printed in the order of service. Lord God, our Father, through our Saviour Jesus Christ, you have assured your children of eternal life, and in baptism have made us one with him. Deliver us from the death of sin, and raise us to new life in your love, in the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, by the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. God, the Holy Trinity, make you strong in faith and love, defend you on every side, and guide you in truth and peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you, and remain with you all.
Amen.
Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ.